version 4.4. So that means that's the Lantern Rite patch, the Chinese New Year. So it's a lot of probably gonna be a lot of things, a lot of new stuff. So let's get into it. Cause as I haven't watched none of this live stream. I was saving all my reactions, commentating for y'all. So this will be cause usually I do watch them beforehand and then obviously rewatch them with y'all and then say whatever I gotta say. But this time I didn't see nothing. Not that I was Gucci. I stayed good boy, and waited for to watch it with y'all. And of course, I already know some of y'all already majority have already watched it, but you can hear my two cents on it now. Let me make sure I got the desktop audio on, so y'all can hear. Wait, can I do it like? Oh wait, no. Let me just have that on.
Have you ever heard of wushou dancing?
Liyue Harbor is always changing, so it is only fitting that Lantern Rite should change in turn.
Oh, he's the new character! I wonder how they're gonna pronounce his name. Is it gaming? Or is it another way of pronouncing it? Yeah, but it's the new four-star character. He's so cute.
Wushou dancing is famous in Chunyu Vale. Performers might be invited to promote the opening of a business or to spread good fortune during a holiday season.
Miss Farina is now one of my esteemed clients!
Oh, Farina! Not... And Nahu Tao getting Farina as a client. Oh, goodness. Since Farina's a human. Well, she always was a human. She was just cursed to be the Archon. But yeah. But now her being... Not she bagging Farina's body already. Ciao.
Is that so?
You're quite right, Miss Hu Tao.
How about we grab some dim sum from Senior Kiosk? My treat.
Oh, he's a claymore. Oh, cool.
Congratulations!
I love that it lights up. Oh.
Up to it, Manzai!
Oh, he's so cute! Oh, a new area. Liyue getting an extension. Okay, yes. We're gonna be going back to Liyue. Obviously for the Lantern Rite and the new addition to the area.
A kite is always tied down no matter how far it flies or how high.
Oh my goodness! Ganyu and I know her name, I got her. What's her name is drawing a blank. Why? I know who she is. Shinhe. Oh, chow. Why? I blanked on her name right there. But ooh, Shinhe and Ganyu's new outfit, new skin. So cute.
Kite soars.
Aww.
Oh, kite born of paper, flying true and set.
Geo Daddy himself, Zhongli.
A lone traveler wanders, just waiting to be found.
I always believed we would see each other again.
Oh! The siblings. Together.
That our days of
Oh, Miss Boop, Miss Thang.
Operation would finally end.
Lantern Rite should be a day of reunion.
I don't know. I don't remember.
You chose a path without a future.
Source of this sin.
Oh, a pretty new enemy, a new boss we gotta fight. Reminds me of the boss from that came with Fontaine, the purple one, the unicorn. The way it moves and all. But this one's blue. And Hydro, not Electra.
One is fast on one's feet.
Miss Cloud retaining herself in her human form. Hey, Queen. I gotta see how to pronounce her name right here, but we know her as Cloud Retainer because she is. But yeah, she look good.
Try to keep pace.
Oh, I definitely see how, because I know she been getting comparisons with Bayonetta, which, let me say Bayonetta. But I've been seeing she get compared with Bayonetta. Oh my goodness. As you already know, me is recovering from a cold. But yeah, she looks so good.
Got him. Make way for the Adeptus.
Okay, they ate this up real good. That trailer for the version.
Hello, travelers. It's your old friend, 大伟.
大家好, 我是阿然. 俏英庄这个名字,大伟哥刚才也说有些印象, 对吧?
是啊, 虽然具体在哪听过, 有点记不太清了.
Oh, that is tiny, child. Let me make this a little bit bigger. Even though I got all my contacts, but come on. Can I make that bigger? There we go. I was like, oh, that's a little tiny.
不过印象里适合茶有关。没错没错，我们陈玉谷的茶庄俏英庄一直都是以香茗猎泉闻名的，身后这个茶府可以说就是俏英庄香茶广受欢迎的秘宝了。这么厉害啊！毕竟这个茶府相传是仙人留下的仙家机关嘛，用它炒出的茶叶香气和口味确实是挺不一般的，而且坊间都流传俏英庄的水土得到过仙人的护佑，
原本就特别适合茶叶生长，哪怕不去考虑仙家机关的加持，茶叶本身的品质就已经非常不错了。虽然我不是什么品茶的这个专业人士啊，但我知道同样挑选上等的茶叶，这茶叶啊也会因为各种因素的影响导致最后味道出现很大差别。听你这么一说啊，我还真挺想尝尝这个仙家机关炒出的茶是什么味道。不过这么特别的茶会不会很难买啊？
大伟哥放心，想喝到俏英庄的茶其实并非难事。俏英庄的后山上都是大片大片的茶田，产出的茶也都会销售到璃月港，甚至
in other nations. Oh wow!
是其他
But this new area is so pretty. Oh, can't wait to go back to 璃月. I'm like, ooh, 璃月 got a new area. We going back.
他国家去。 而且热情的俏英庄居民本身就很喜欢喝茶，也很乐于用好茶来招待客人呢。比方说，你要是遇到嘉明，他肯定得把松萝仙芽、油韵丹丛等等好茶都给你泡上尝尝。谢谢嘉明。还有啊，说到嘉明这个名字啊，听着就很亲切。嘉明他的性格热情健谈，大家也都很喜欢和他相处。虽然说他的老家是在俏英庄， 但他人却经常在璃月港和仪陇部两地之间往返，他的主业是镖师，还有个副业是表演武兽戏，还有副业啊，年轻人的精神比较好，那我猜啊，
Oh, we got a side hustle, okay. He said getting that money.
副业才是他真正想做的事吧？大伟哥，你好会猜，嘉明的确非常喜欢武兽戏。
并且把表演武兽戏当作
Man, his design is so it's so cool with the reds and greens and the blacks, like really lovely. Chef kiss. I like how his hair half up and half down too. Little ponytail a little back in the back right there, and the rest of his hair down, and it's like red too. Yes.
做自己梦想的事业，但他在这过程中还是吃了不少苦头，还跟家里人闹得不太开心。不过佳明对武兽戏还真不是三分钟热度。他骨子里还是个很有坚持的人，他坚定地想要表演好武兽戏，在璃月港甚至更远的地方做出成绩，这也是为了证明给家里看吧。最终他离开了。
If y'all see me pausing, I'm trying to read, the subtitles as well. Maybe go too fast.
在家去追求梦想，虽然现在的生活有点辛苦，但佳明自己还算过得开心。
哎呀，感觉他真的很有冲劲和闯劲啊！有机会还真挺想去看看他的武术戏。
机会说不定已经近在眼前了哦。
哦，这感情好啊！
佳明这么喜爱武术戏。他的技能天赋当然也和他有关了，要不然我就先给大伟哥介绍介绍，也算是提前满足一下你的好奇了。
原来是这么个近在眼前啊，可以可以。
Let's see how he.
Whether it takes me uphill, downhill, or out to the sticks, I get the goods from A to B. I'll even take him across the sea if needed. So don't worry, you're in safe hands. They don't call me the.
Oh, his little buddy is so cute. And his voice, very fitting for him. Very fitting. I like, love it.Well, let's see his little buddy again.
And take him across the sea if needed. So don't worry, you're in.
Look at him!
Safe hands.
Aww.
They don't call me the gold standard guard for nothing. Congratulations! Hop to it, Manzai!
Manzai? That's how you say it? Adorable.
佳明会将自己的武兽之法应用在各种场合，战斗中，佳明高举兽首向前腾跃，在接触到目标或地形时向上腾空起跳，此时能进行格外强劲的下落攻击，对敌人造成火元素伤害。不过，以这种形式释放的下落攻击会使佳明在落地时消耗部分生命。
Loses HP. He lands. Oh, I'm losing his HP. Chill.
生命值是释放的下落攻击，会使佳明在落地时消耗部分生命值。好在佳明的攻击会使佳明在落地时消耗部分生命值。好在佳明有好伙伴文仔的协助，当他在施展灿焰金泥舞，召唤出文仔出场时。佳明将会恢复一定生命值，并造成火元素范围。
Oh, he restores the amount of HP and deals AOE pyro damage. Oh, so that mechanic's not only tied to Fontaine characters.
范围伤害，和文仔合力表演精彩的武兽戏。当文仔和佳明汇合时，还能帮助佳明恢复力气。让他的元素战绩瑞兽登高
，But his rest of his outfit lights up as well.
高楼
，so neat.
能够立刻再次使用武兽态势持续期间，只要佳明状态上佳，还可再次。
佳明 ，Wait, let me. I need to make sure I'm saying his fucking name right. I'm just like, wait. And y'all know me and what words are hard, so I need to see something real quick. Let me see Shroom. It's not telling me.
换出文仔登场助力，
好精彩啊！这战斗啊，真像看了一场武兽戏。
能让大伟哥有这样的观感就太好了。在创作佳明的过程中，我们学习并借鉴了舞狮这门传统文化中的很多元素，比如跳跃、蹲桩、打滚、弓步、扣步等等。再和现代元素相结合， 想要为大家呈现出一种具有霓虹质感和火焰包裹的全新武兽系。
Neon lighting texture, oh, yes.
硬光舞狮，有心了，有心了，我感觉啊，确实挺新奇的。
另外，战斗聚焦在跳跃这个核心元素上呢，也是想给大家传达一种步步高升的节庆氛围。还有文仔的加入，也希望在补足连击丰富度的同时，呈现出双狮合舞的感觉。
这要是再敲个锣、打个鼓啊，喜庆的节日感一下子就出来了啊！
是呀，而且说到海灯节，今年也有一位老朋友要来和我们一起过节。
我知道，那个女人，
那 Lady Bird，
没错，就是那个女人，流云界风真君。果然大家都很喜欢她啊。
哎，说到流云真君啊，我想起来刚才收到了个消息啊，项目的同学啊给我发了个流云界风真君的视频，说是看完后啊能更了解她。我还没来得及看来着，
来得早不如来得巧啊！
来，和大家一起来看看。
Oh, we want to see behind the scenes of them. Cloud Retainer in her human form. Oh, it's so neat to see the behind the scenes and the workings of all of it.
Hello, 大家好呀。现在闲云的开发进度已经接近尾声了，或许大家和我一样也想知道研发同学们对这个角色有怎样的看法，那现在就让我们一起去采访一下他们吧。哎，同学，能和我们聊一聊制作闲云这个角色的初衷吗？
其实很久以前啊，我们就有了将流云界风真君化作人形游历世间的想法，正好呢恰逢这次海灯节，为了让他就是出现在今后的故事
To make her appear in the future source and then more natural.
你们更加自然，更加顺畅吧。
Also, that means she's gonna be incorporated more into the future. You need to create her character image. We couldn't stay using her bird form. It wasn't a smooth. Into the script of her being a bird.In her truest form, she had her human form.
我们就借这次机会呢，去把她的形象制作出来，并且给她起了一个更加适合在人世间行走的名字，叫闲云。
在原神的玩法里，还是有很多可以挖掘的潜力。我就以下路攻击来举例吧。其实这个玩法在我们游戏中一直都存在，但其实在实战中很少有角色能用得出来。所以这一次我们想尝试制作一个角色。她自身不仅有特殊的下路攻击。
Oh, I love her plunging attack. Me trying to read the bottom and trying to look at the image. So I'm like bouncing back and forth. Plunging attack herself.
同时还能够把这一个玩法推广到更多的角色身上，并在实战中加以运用。
因为我自己特别喜欢在大世界里乱跑，所以想做一个快乐的跑图人。
我们特效能够在里面做一些人后化形的表现，想象应该会很帅的。
他的仙气和机关术的结合还挺让人兴奋的。
谁不喜欢那个女人呢？
因为组织安排。
我不知道。
当然了，在制作的过程中，我们也会遇到一些问题。
啊？什么问题？闲鱼又出 bug 了。
机关术当时做起来其实并不是很容易，因为它不能太有科幻感。同时呢，又要保持他的高级感。
闲人的动作，他既要仙气飘飘，同时
啊 ，wait go back， wait go back， go back， go back， go
back， 同
one two five seven， you let me give you high up， high up， high roll。
同时呢，又要保持他的高级感。
闲人的动作，
嗯，他 yeah， this is what I want to come back to。嗯，他 to have both airy adaptive quality。 Yeah， because I'm I definitely noticed that。Which makes sense because she's obviously animal and she's a bird. Adeptus bird. I'm like, Adepti. So I'm just like, that makes sense. She gotta be airy and all. Imagine if she wasn't animal. It'd be funny. She wasn't. But yeah.
他既要仙气飘飘，同时也要兼顾工科女的感觉。
在打磨元素战绩的过程当中遇到过一些问题。 有节奏的释放元素战技其实是它的核心操作策略。
移动方面既要考虑空中的位移，又要考虑落地衔接的各种表现，还要考虑美术位移和程序位移之间的平衡关系。
元素战技在俯冲下来的时候很难观察到敌人，
变后冲击的镜头开始还是挺眩晕的，
提升了我的抗眩晕等级，
不过整体感觉还是挺顺利的，挺顺利的。
唉，那么最后大家还有什么想和玩家们说说的呢？
希望在 4.4 版本呢，我们大家都能从忙碌的生活中找到属于自己的清静，也希望大家能够喜欢上闲云小姐的故事。
The story. I can't wait for her story quest. Speaking of her story, I'm like, yeah, can't wait for that story quest. Cannot wait.
祝大家今年海灯节快乐，
希望大家多多玩原神，
祝大家都能抽到自己想要的角色。
大家享受跑图的乐趣吧。
希望新的一年大家都能准时下班。
别骂了，别骂了，求求了，求求。
在这里工作挺有意思的，希望有更多小伙伴一起加入原神。
不要和玄云握手，那是仙人掌。
那就给旅行者们拜个早年吧。
希望原 bug 区的 UP 主们能让我们过个好年。
喂。We have to spend our new year fixing bugs. Hopefully not. Hopefully y'all do not have to do that.
那么今天的采访，
就
到这里结束啦。希望各位旅行者们能喜欢仙云这个角色。大家再见。
We love a woman project manager. We love to see it.But I like that cool, like, little behind the scenes of how they made Cloud Retainer's human form. And I'm like, yes. Very neat.
不愧是那个女人，就连制作幕后都这么有个性。说起来，这还是她第一次以人形的样貌见我们吧。
The character model, we already said, she's eating. The outfit, amazing. The boobs are boobin', legit looking like...Looking like coconuts right here. Coconuts. Like, ciao. And then this in between the girlies, I'm just like, so pretty. She's a whole legit moment. Let me play Wendy. Where's she at? A whole moment she is.
She's got a point. She's an icon. She's a legend. And she is the moment.
Come on now.
Now, come on now.
But yeah, she looks so good.
她这幅打扮虽然之前出现过，不过在我们面前大大方方的走来走去，确实还是第一次。
看来这里面又有故事，那她今年打算怎么过节呢？
这就要说到我们今年海灯节的主题——风筝。现在人间的机关造物可是越来越稀奇古怪了。
风筝，这也不算什么稀奇古怪吧？
之前呢，确实不算。但今年从枫丹那边引进了神奇的机械装置，能够让风筝无风自起，飞得又高又稳。
你这么一说我就懂了，流云剑风真君一定是起了莫名的攀比心吧？什么枫丹科技肯定比不过本仙的发明创造。
看来大伟哥真的很熟悉这位老朋友啊，完全正确。
那个女人太可爱了。
是呀，她虽然脾气不小，但性格一点也不差。敢爱敢恨，作风正直又富有侠义心肠，有时候好像有些心口不一，有时候又还有一点脱线，可他的幽默总是能让人印象深刻。
是的，虽然是个仙人呐，但非常有亲切感，真像是一位热心的邻居。
在流云界风真君以闲云之名正式入住离月。
喂，我刚刚想说是
月港成为我们的邻居之前，他到底经历了些什么？大伟哥肯定也很好奇他过去的故事吧。哎呀，我的聊天讲故事的本事肯定没他好，不如到时候亲自去找他。
Her story request, yes, cannot wait to hear and her story request.You should go and ask her in person. Yeah, can't wait to get her backstory. Like, girly, what is human form came from? What do you decide now to be immersed with the humans?
了解一下，就让我们一起期待海灯节以及仙鹤之章吧。
可以，每次有流云真君的剧情啊，都挺欢乐的，我很期待。
Yeah, she do like some stories.
我们是不是该改口叫她闲云了？
没错，那我也来分享一下闲云在战斗时的风采吧。
The secrets of
the mechanical arts are too profound to convey in a few simple words. Oh, but why must the listener grow weary whenever I begin to divulge them? Skyward!
Oh, her attack pattern is so pretty. Go back. Let me see it again. I'm trying to hear her voice because I wonder, I think it's the same voice actor who plays her. But of course, it's not, her voice is not so ethereal and all that. It's very, what you would think her voice would sound like when she was a human. Which is the same, but not as grand. Godly, adeptist-y.
Secrets of the mechanical arts are too profound to convey in a few simple words. Oh, but why must the listener grow weary whenever I begin to divulge them?
Oh, I love how pretty her attacks is. Ugh, I'm a sucker for things looking cute and pretty.
Skyward!
And she turns into her adept self and then plunges into the ground. Yes. And swirls the enemies together.
Stray clouds converge!
Liu Yun Jie Feng Zhen Jun 这个称号，再加上鹤的外形，不难让人联想出轻盈御风的仙人形象。闲云能进行至多。
This is her E. Can be used while mid air. Oh, we can use this in mid air. We love that. Modena, dark as all. Blah 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 blah.Style letters.
三次的特殊跳跃步天梯，并且能根据具体情况在后两段中选择。
Yeah, good. So yeah, she's gonna be sucking in the enemies, pulling them together. Love that.
地面释放或是在空中释放。
And also too, this is good. Good for exploration as well.
这个过程中还能化形为鹤进行特殊的下落攻击。不仅如此，仙云更能轻唤仙风，召唤自己引以为傲的发明创造机关竹心，在持续恢复同。
哇，不知名。Okay, so her alt restores HP.
同伴生命值的同时
，and also too helps him leap into midair as well.Wait, I wonder if you use Zhao, his ult, and then use Cloud Retainer's ult, because Zhao can already jump in the air and do plunging. But I'm like, can he go even higher with Cloud Retainer's ult as well? I'm curious. I'm definitely going to try that. I know some people are already going to like try that using Zhao and her ult, and then him jumping into. I'm like, I wonder, can he go higher?
也能御风助推。让同伴获得轻盈的跳跃能力，提升跳跃的高度，并在同伴完成下落攻击时
，until AOE animal damage when they perform plunge. Oh, it does additional damage as well. Animal damage as well. Yes.
造成风元素范围伤害，让整个队伍都如有仙助。
看起来很有意思啊，身形轻盈，来去如风，而且还能为大家提供协助。就像是一位默默关照他人的热心长辈。
是的，希望能把闲云的这份人格魅力传递给大家。
那除了这两位有趣的角色之外，这次我们还有机会邀请到哪些角色入队呢？
那就来看看4.4版。
Oh, we get into the wishes, love. I got a lot to say.
本的活动祈愿吧，在4.4版本，闲云与那些。
My queen is back. She's back.Nahida is gonna be running up against her, well, alongside her. I'm so happy to see Nahida back on the banners. Oh, she looks so cute. my first Archon I ever got. Because if y'all, for y'all who don't know, Nahida was my first Archon. She was on a 50-50. Child, it was scary. This was back when I wasn't being a whole whale in Genshin. She was a 50. I remember like it was yesterday. She was a 50-50. I was scrounging for intertwined fates, and I was like, I think I pulled one. It was one roll. I don't think it was a 10 roll when I seen the 5 gold come. I think it was like one roll, and I was scared. I was like, it better be her. She'll be my first Archon, and she was. She came. I loved it. But yeah, so yeah, Nahida and Cloud Retainer, all with the new character, 4-star character as well. So good, we don't have to wait until they didn't put him in phase 2. They put him in phase 1. So Gucci. But yeah, this is what I'm gonna tell you. I seen this. I got spoiled a little bit. I seen this some hours ago, a little earlier. I was like, damn, I didn't mean to see it, but I saw. I was like, damn, Nahida is running with her. I was like. Because I wanted to try to get Nahida's weapon, but I don't think I can because I want to get Cloud Retainer. I want to get her because I love her. I know Cloud as a character already. She's something. From the few times I interacted with she is something. But no, I do want Cloud Retainer. Her combat style looks like, it's just so pretty. Her whole aesthetic, I love it. So I'm like, I do want to get her, but I wanted to try to get Nahida's weapon. Like, because I got Nubilette's, because I love Nubilette so much. I got his weapon. I want to get Nahida, because my two ultimate favorites, because I got a lot of characters I love, and like, obviously, but Nahida and Nubilette are just, top tier for me. And I'm just like, I got Nubilette's weapon. I wanted to get Nahida's weapon, and I don't know if I'm gonna get it. I'm a whale, but I ain't that of a whale, much of a whale. We can't be spending like that. But I'm just like, but I want her weapon. And I got lucky with Nubilette's weapon. It came home on the first, seeing the first thing go gold. So I'm like, I don't know. I probably get drugged through the mud if I try to get Nahida's. And then end up getting Cloud Retainer's weapon or the weapon off the Santa Banner. The weapon banner is so sketchy as it is in a whole. So I'm like, ugh. But I might have to wait to get Nahida's weapon until she get another rerun. But I'm just like, damn. I was kind of hoping she was in the second phase, and I'm like, I could. But I don't know. But I definitely want to get Cloud Retainer though. So I know that for sure. She will be coming home. She will be. But can't wait to constellations of him though.
Well.
达将会在第一期活动祈愿中出现，并提升获取概率，同时加名的获取概率也将大幅提升。全新五星法器鹤鸣鱼鹰也将。
Her weapon looks so pretty, oh, so gorgeous.
将出现在同期的武器活动祈愿。
See, the weapon banner is such a pain. They really should split the weapon banner up because I can't. It's so, just the weapon banner hurts so many souls. Cause I'm just like, ugh. I can't be rubbing my eye. I got in contact, shoot. But I'm just rubbing the corner. But yeah. They really should do how they do in Honkai and have the weapon banners separate from each other for the different characters instead of together. Phase 2. Zhao and Yaimiko! Okay. Of course Zhao will be running back. Lantern Ray. Of course he gotta make his rerun. And I did get Zhao last year around this time. Because A didn't want to come home. So I was guaranteed the banner character. So I'm like, let me get Zhao. Because I do like playing with Zhao. He's fun to play with. And left his character in the game. And Yaimiko, I already got my girl. Yeah, no, I got Yai. I got Yai around like Valentine's Day of, I forgot what year, 2020, what year? That's a sexy weapon? Yeah, glitch it is. I forgot what year I got Yamiko. It was 2021 or two, one of those. It'd been that long. Wow.
4铁将迎来复刻，并获得概率 up。那我的分享就告一段落了，大伟哥可以去仪容部那边看看，那里还会有其他同事来和大伟哥讲讲陈玉谷的故事。
好的好的，也谢谢阿兰的分享。那么在去仪容部之前啊，我们先来看看第一组兑换码吧。
All the codes, they probably already expired. I don't know if y'all can get them still or not, but I did get mine though earlier. Cause they did send out an email about the code, so yeah, I got them. So I wouldn't wait too long till they expire. The music just sounds so good, so soothing. My eye. Oh my goodness. Pretty instrument, very pretty.
大伟哥，你感觉沉玉谷的景色怎么样？
我还没看到太多，目前感觉还挺美的，有种世外桃源的感觉。
大伟哥爱挺敏锐，沉玉谷这里流传着很多与仙人有关的传说，还真有点世外桃源的味道，
是吧？而且目前看来啊，沉玉谷这边的人文建筑好像都有点徽派建筑的味道。
没错没错，就拿俏英庄来说吧，它依山傍水，因势而建，附近还有。
Next to the mountains and water, many streams of rivers nearby. Oh, many streams and rivers nearby. But as I said, y'all, it's beautiful, gorgeous. The colors, ah.
有不少溪流河川，而徽派建筑这种白墙。黑瓦色彩分明的特点就更是锦上添花，让村落看上去鳞次栉比，井然有序。
哎，说起水啊，沉玉谷这边水还挺多的，一路上大大小小的溪流河川可是真不少。仪陇部这里啊，还有条这么高这么大的瀑布，气势很磅礴啊。
确实，这就得给大伟哥讲讲仪陇部这里流传的传说了。
哦，
大伟哥应该知道，离月港的人们都相信这片土地最早的主人就是阎王爷，先民正是跟随着阎王帝君，在他的护佑下才建立起了繁荣的城市和港口。
听起来还有个但是。
不错，但是在沉玉谷也有人相信，除了阎王爷以外，还有别的魔神和众仙保佑着沉玉谷先民的祖先。比如说啊，在仪陇部这里，大家都听过一个传说，关于一位名叫福井的鲤鱼仙人。
难怪这里有不少鲤鱼形状的灯啊，应该也是出于这个原因吧。
嗯，也可以这么想，在当地的传说中啊，金色的鲤鱼可是好运的象征呢。
而且仪陇部衔接着枫丹，是两国之间重要的交通贸易枢纽，嘉明任职的剑侠镖局就在仪陇部。可以看到仪陇部本身的地势非常高，自古就是座难以攀援的高山，在过去的传说中也曾是仙人隐居之处。后来呀，因为种种缘故，一些先民迁居至此，形成了新的聚落。为了解决这瀑布高悬带来的不便，人们修建了一座高大的水利升降机。
Oh, what a pair of lips.
哦，原来如此，他们的成果还真是壮观啊。
是呀，而且这瀑布之下还有一条蜿蜒曲折的大河，贯穿整个沉玉谷。
既然已经说到了这条河，我们沿着河川看过去，大伟哥应该也注意到了河道上那。
Oh wow! Oh wow! Oh wow! just a wow! Like oh my god! Oh wow! There's no other words I can say but pretty gorgeous. Y'all already know. I don't have to say it. Immaculate. Yes. Continue.
那对巨大的玉珏了吧？那里就是宝珏口，算是沉玉谷中最有名的地标之一了。
是呀。这对玉珏应该也是过去的仙人留下的吧，像这么壮观又瑰丽的景色，应该也只有仙人能创造出来吧。
传说宝珏口的这对玉珏就是仙人为了保护人民防洪治涝而投下的。
哈哈，心系人民的仙人确实还挺值得大家敬爱啊。这里的种种传说啊，听上去感觉还挺浪漫的。
是的，我们也来看看沉玉谷的其他地方吧。像柠檬山是历史悠久的古华派的发祥之地，耀蝶谷和悬链山就分别是传说中白蛇和鲤鱼仙人的住所，还有南方的赤章城垣是属于昔日冲突的遗迹。
沉玉谷还真辽阔啊，
和刚才说的一样，这片土地上还到处都遗留着仙人的足迹，宝器啊，洞府啊，说不定就散落在这雾气缭绕的高山之间呢。
你别说，沉玉谷也有不少高山，但我总感觉和以往常见的离月山岩还不太一样。
沉玉谷这边的山岭更像是峰峦叠嶂的黄山，这些山岚的颜色好像是水墨画一样，时不时还会有一抹灵动的青色晕染，再加上山岭之间还藏着各种各样的奇特景观，我就觉得呀，沉玉谷之所以会有这么多仙人的传说观，我竟然再加上山岭之间还藏着各种各样的奇特景观我就觉得呀， 沉玉谷之所以会有这么多仙人的传说。
Oh, there's some marks there.
流传后世，和这种独一无二的地理风貌应该是密不可分的吧？
感觉是这个道理。大自然还真有鬼斧神工啊！
当你漫游沉玉谷的时候，登临山岭高处，就会看到那些跌宕起伏的云海，根据日光的变化，呈现出异彩纷呈的华美景象。缭绕的云雾轻轻拂过你的身边，简直就像是置身仙境一样。
哎呀，你也太会描述景色了，说的我的期待值都拉满了。
还不止这些哦，除了仙迹和美景，沉玉谷中还栖息着传说中的灵兽哦。
Of course.
比如隐山泥兽，根据本地老人。
The beast is just so ethereal. Ugh.Just look at them. They just know they're the shit, and they are. They are. They saying we will get dog walked when we battle, and I'm like, yeah, I wouldn't mind it. You look just so good, and you all my shades of blue too. I'm like, yes, I wouldn't mind dog walk me.Would not mind.
人的说法，他们是这片土地原本的主人，如今。
Look, oh, so cute and pretty. I can't look like a whole cloud, a blue cloud. The different shades of blue. Oh, you already know. Me googling over my color palette, yes. Just the different shades of blue, all the details. Oh.
隐居在崇山峻岭之间，虽然说是。
They just know they're so pretty. Ah.
是传说中的祥瑞之兽，但若是有人贸然闯入他们的领地，打扰了他们。
I feel like they're gonna be doing animal too.I see a lot of, I see Hydra, is it going to be animal?
的安宁也是会被毫不留情地赶出去的哦。
Yeah, yeah, they're going to be Hydra and animal. They say they can do both at the same time. I'm like, okay.
他的外形啊，包括战斗表现都好仙好灵哦，我喜欢。
顺带一提，仪农部家喻户晓的武兽戏，这就是以传说中离兽的形象为原型进行的表演。嘉明身边的文仔其实也是离兽哦。
看来这之间也有故事啊，
那就来看看隐山离兽的故事吧。
Oh, that's quite the inquiry, Gaming.
Gaming, Gaming. Oh, that. Oh, okay, okay. So I was saying gaming, Gaming. Okay, whew, I was like, it was close in range. So Gaming, Gaming. Okay. It's all about the pronunciation.
So, are the stories true, sir?
Patience now. Any discussion of this beast must first begin with Chen Yu Vale, a land of tiered peaks shrouded in billowing mist, replete with stories of illuminated beasts. As for the subject of your curiosity, let us call it the Solitary Swanee.
Swanee, that's what it's called.
It is a symbolic and auspicious animal.
Well, that's how you say it, Swanee.
Said to be related to the Adepti. Legends say the Swanee traverses the land under the cover of mist. Its presence nearly indetectable, save only for the faintest outline of horns. When at ease, it rests with its eyes closed and legs crossed.Yet should the situation turn dangerous, the fury of the Swanee will be unleashed. It moves with the swiftness of windswept clouds, and attacks with the ferocity of a roaring waterfall. But some people say this time of peace has forced the Swanee into a life of seclusion far beyond our reach. Still,Those are just a few old legends I've heard in my time. Getting all that across in a wushu dance might prove tricky, no?
It's like anything. Practice makes perfect. I just gotta work at it. You see?
Nanzai agrees with me.
Nanzai is so cute. Oh, love him. Love him. I love him so much.
Chenyugu 这么辽阔，一下子是讲不完的。最近成玉谷的水土发生了一些变化，就连香茶的气味也变得不如从前了。到时候还烦请各位旅行者跟随仙人的指引，帮助解决困扰俏音庄居民的茶叶问题吧。
再次感谢两位同学给我们带来了这么精彩的成玉谷介绍以及传说故事。那接下来我们稍作休息，准备了解一下今年海灯节的活动吧。那在这之前呢，还请一起看看第二组兑换码吧。
Second code that probably is expired. But yeah, Chengyu, it looks so gorgeous. Gorgeous. All the different colors, shade. Oh, so pretty, so pretty. And now I know it's Gaming. That's how you say his name. Love it.But yeah, but I cannot wait to just run around the new area in Liyue. Oh. Because I love me some exploring and just running around crazy. And also, we can just see their outfits right here as well. Ganyu and Shinho's outfits. Ah, yes.
各位欢迎回来，接下来啊，就让我们和阿明一起来看看今年的海灯节吧。
大伟哥好呀。
哎，你好你好。听了刚才一些铺垫啊，我还真挺期待今年海灯节的。今年都会有些什么样的惊喜呢？
那么我就来抛砖引玉一下。刚才阿然也提到，今年海灯节的主题是风筝，还将璃月的传统手工艺风筝与枫丹的械动式垂直拉升装置进行了结合。
机械风筝，不知道和流云真君的机关比起来，哪个技术力更强啊？
这可不好说呀。
哎，我小时候也放过风筝，但其实我对风筝了解不是特别多。为什么会选用风筝来当主题呢？
我想可能是它能承载人们众多的美好祝愿吧。
这倒是和宵灯有异曲同工之妙啊。
这么一说，风筝还真就像是白天的宵灯，不过我们这次的风筝在晚上也会发光哦。
我们平时最常见的风筝应该是飞鸟图案吧。我记得有传说是古人受到飞鸟启发创作了风筝，表达对美好生活的追求。
哎，是啊，我以前放的也是燕子风筝，
不过现在已经有很多不同样式的风筝了，一些具有吉祥寓意的图案还挺受欢迎的，比如锦鲤、龙凤、彩蝶，这些图案都很有特色，除了表达美好的祝愿，也能让看到的人们感受到
没有I feel blessed. They better be blessing my rolls for cloud retainer.
这放风筝本身也是非常有益身心的活动。
是的，大伟哥也可以先来海灯节里体验体验。
而且在今年海灯节上，甘雨和申鹤将会穿着流云借风真君请人特别定制的新衣装，来和大家共度佳节。
Oh, Clara Tanner, commissioned those outfits for them. Yes, she said, "I gotta get my daughters. I had to get my daughters right for this lantern right." I'm like, "Yeah, she better. She better."
没错，同时行秋也准备了一套新衣装，只要游玩海灯节活动达到特定目标，就能够免费获得。
哇，那快看看老朋友们的新衣装是什么样子的呢
？I heard free. What's free?
新衣装，来和大家共度佳节。
没错。同时行秋也
准
备了一套新衣装，只要游玩海灯
节Golden Lantern Ray
达到特定目标就能够免
we love free skin. Xingqiu's outfit's free, of course.
免费获得。
哇，那快看看老朋友们的新衣装是什么样子的呢？
Okay, give me very much Fontaine from the top. on you, your outfit's so pretty, girl. Love the bow in the back. Let me go back. Let me see the back. But yeah, loving all this blue. I've just been seeing a lot of, I'm living and loving, laughing forever. All of it. Oh, and his hair is in a shmini, little ponytail. I wonder how you got it back to get it like that. But the back of her, so pretty. So pretty. Oh, and her hair's up. In a bun. In the headpiece, too. Gorgeous. So pretty. I love fashion impact. Yes. Shinha. Just eating it up. That go off walk. The walk. She knows. Yes.
确实好看，明明是来给大伟哥介绍海灯节的，我自己都想快点入手新衣装了。那我赶紧来讲讲今年海灯节上都有一些什么有意思的活动吧。
好嘞，
今年海灯节上主要有三个游玩活动，分别是指引巡遥、瑞兽欢悦和异光云行。
感觉光听名字就能有一个模糊的概念了。
他们的灵感源自各种传统文化，不过我们就像客勤一样，也在学习，尝试推陈出新。
好，快讲讲怎么个推陈出新法。
那先来说说这个指引巡遥吧。拆解名字的话，就是用指引的形式来寻觅佳肴。璃月有一种流传已久的艺术指引具，灵活运用画片和灯具，可以让画面在幕布上活起来，再结合枫丹的映影相关技术，改编成一种新颖的互动游戏。
Okay, Fontaine collab with Li Wei.
游戏叫做剪纸戏，主要会讲述些简单明快的故事，让观众们会心一笑。
我大概有概念了啊，结合这张锅巴和月桂的图啊，这出剪纸戏应该是引导锅巴和月桂去找食材。
Oh yeah, 月桂，锅巴月桂啊 ，so cute.
来做美食的故事吧。
哎，被大伟哥猜对了。
没错。这个活动玩法呢，操作上比较简单，老少皆宜。我们需要控制锅巴和月桂进行移动，在特定的步数限制下解开谜题，破除障碍，最后一起收集到食材，就可以成功烹饪出各种美味佳肴了。
Oh, this is so cute and easy. Yes.
这个规则是不是看起来还蛮简单的？
的确，门槛不高，玩一遍应该就会了，确实很有节庆气氛。
不过呢，也不要太过小看这个游戏了。在后几关挑战中，可能需要引导锅巴与月桂互相配合，比如让锅巴去推动月桂乘坐的小车，这样月桂就能在不同的起始点开始行动，也能节省下一些步数。
有意思。
Take it. There could be some brain power to use. Okay.
是，像是推箱子一样。
第二个活动，瑞兽欢悦，是五兽队在五兽系的基础上进行了简化以及趣味性改良的碰碰五兽系玩法。希望大家能够在茶余饭后活动活动，同时也能亲身感受一下武兽系的魅力。
哎，不错哎，武兽系啊，看着就挺有意思的，但要自己去体验武兽门槛还是有点高的。那这个趣味活动啊，说不定能给我们带来不一样的火花。
这个火花可是靠碰撞出来的哦。这个活动共有三个关卡：立誓连连来、时节竞登高和彩青征集照。我们可以通过匹配让店家帮忙组局，也可以自行邀请亲朋好友组团游玩。当进入关卡场地后，我们需要在限定时间内达成不同的关卡目标，尽可能取得更高的评分。在这个过程中，还可以穿戴特制的武兽系玩偶服，进入武兽碰碰状态，弹开触碰到的其他玩家，
感觉会很欢乐哎。
确实很欢乐，而且在游玩过程中还可以稍微使点小坏，弹开其他朋友来争夺更多的积分。
哎，要是约上的是几个损友啊，他们大概宁愿不去抢积分，也要来弹开我。
那也不能光顾着使坏啊， 三个关卡还是有一些特定规则的，比如力士连连来最容易上手，最重要的目标就是去争夺尽可能多的力士茶饼，去弹开别的玩家也能获得他掉落的茶饼。时节竞登高，还额外要去抢占时不时出现的高地来保持豪气值，同时也可以通过弹开别的玩家让他抢不到高地。彩星征集绕的话，主要就是要前往时不时刷新的安全区域里，规避掉麻辣气氛的影响，从而保持清淡值。当然既然出现了安全区域，
也就是说可以去弹开别的玩家，让他进不了安全区域，一直被麻辣锅气冲击，是吧？
好像大伟哥已经懂了，领先损友一步。
最后一个活动，异光云行，我们可以借助金里浮月的力量，在烟花绽放的空中穿梭，并在这个过程中收集尽可能多的玉莲灯笼来积累得分。还请放心，金
Oh yeah, they had this one before last year. I don't got one.
金里会一直保护我们，不会让烟花伤害到我们的。
化为金里穿梭于烟花绽放的夜空中，听起来就很浪漫。
希望海灯节的故事与活动能把这份喜庆又吉祥的节日气氛传达给每一位旅行者。当节庆热度足够高涨，各位可以
Of course invite a four-star character from Liyue to of your choice. We eat this up every time. So yes, any four-star Liyue character we get to pick, we love it.So if you can't get your hand on Gaming, well, you can get him in the character select, four-star character select.
十位璃月四星角色中任。
Wait, how many? Oh, well, damn! 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 Pyro characters from 璃月. Only 1 Hydro, that's a 4-star. 1 Cairo, that's a 4-star. 2 Geos.One Electro and one Dendro. Okay.
任选一位，邀请加入到自己的队伍中来，其中也包括我们的新朋友佳明哦。累计登录活动“富贵登门”也会在海灯节期间开放。
All the rewards and promotions. Yes. Got the main event, the character choose, charge.May fortune find you, the intertwined fates to log in. Yeah, we love that. Enter gifts. Wait, what is this? Wait, is it the out? Oh, yeah. I was like, wait, what is this? It's the outfits, the skins. Okay. And then his skin. Okay, Gucci.
旅行者们可以领取最多十枚纠缠之源在内的奖励，同时为
，But I'm definitely I'm a get Shinto out. I'm gonna see, cause I know I gotta get Cloud Tanner first. I gotta get Miss Ma'am first, and then I can think about getting. Although I probably will get Shinto's outfit, cause it's really cute, and I have her.I don't got Ganyu, but I can still get her outfit. But I'm like, I don't have her yet. I have to get her outfit at its full price. Whenever she drove back around, and then of course he for free. I don't have to spend nothing to get him. You'll get him for free from the Lantern event. So Ryuji, but yeah.
为了感谢旅行者们在过去一年里的支持与陪伴。我们还将通过游戏内邮件的方式为旅行者们奉上三个纠缠之源，
希望在这海灯佳节之际，大家都能放飞承载梦想与祝愿的风筝，乘风到达理想的地方。
没错，也祝愿各位能和亲朋好友一同享受欢乐的时光。
说得对啊，不过我们的节目还没有结束，让我们先休息一下，看看第三组兑换码吧。
Another break.And the last code, which probably is expired by now. Man, everybody looking so cute and all the stuff. The Lantern Rite stuff, the new area, just, oh. Ganyu and Shinha and Shingsha's outfits are eating. We love it. As I said, love me some Fashion Impact. Yeah, I wonder what else they gotta show. Show off. Oh, she ate that. Wait, go back. She ate that. Oh, wait a minute. The way she said, dude, she ate that with the finger work. I was like, ooh, she ate that up. Look at her finger. Look at her fingers. Like, ooh. Queen. That up too? Yes, they all eaten, obviously. Ooh.
现在已经吸引到越来越多不同地区的朋友前来游玩了。
喂，哒哒哒哒，那个，让他们走走走走。哦 ，Who coming？
当然知道，上次温迪不就来海豚节了吗？怎
么说？ He
did. 今年又有新面孔？
是啊是啊，今年的话，不仅有一些朋友会来璃月共度海豚节，还有其他熟人来到了望舒客栈。
这是来尝璃月菜来了。
虽然可能初衷不是这个，但就结果来看确实是这样。起因其实是我们接下了望舒客栈的委托，暂时接手受伤的严笑，成为了望舒客栈的代理大厨，满足远道而来的客人们对璃月佳肴的好奇心。
让我想到了一句老话，叫有朋自远方来，
不亦乐乎。蒙德、道七、须弥和枫丹都会有我们熟悉的朋友们前来，至于他们的目的以及在这里发生了什么，就请各位旅行者届时亲自去揭晓答案吧。
那看来必须得好好。
喂，
不亦乐乎，蒙德。
Yes, there will be familiar faces.
须弥和枫丹都会有我们熟。
From Monster Inazuma, Sumeru, and oh damn, everybody from every nation coming? Not every. I know all of them can't be Liu Wei. But I'm like.Certain selected few people are coming from the other nations. I'm like, ooh, I wonder who. If Nahida comes to Liyue, I'll lose my shit. I'll lose it. I'll legit lose it. Y'all gonna be seeing me squeal if I see Nahida come for Lantern. I'll legit go crazy. And I wonder if Nouvellette gonna be coming from Fontaine. From Fontaine to later. I will lose my two faves right there, my two ultimate faves. Eat it up.
熟悉的朋友们前来，至于他们的目的以及在这里发生了什么。
就请各位旅行者届时亲自去揭晓答案吧。那看来必须得好好露一手，让他们尝尝地道的梨粤菜了。那肯定了，我们需要连续。
And we cook it for them too.
去进行改刀、调配、烹制这三个步骤，来烹饪出符合客人需求的菜肴。最后再对菜品进行摆盘装饰，就可以要。
Oh, we get them presented and make it look nice and pretty. Love it.
邀请客人们品尝了，不错不错。
招待朋友这事我最开心了。另外，最近蒙德也正发生着一些神秘事件，有些神秘的雕像突兀地出现在达达乌帕谷中，导致丘丘人部落中的丘丘人们突然变得举止反常起来。这时候就需要我们前去调查其中暗藏的真相和秘密了，对吧？
没错，大伟哥已经是一位非常优秀的旅行者了，
毕竟也旅行了这么久。
我们需要先操控乌帕诺之眼，依附在丘丘人与风石莱姆身上，潜入部落营地中，同时需要小心地避开或者干扰那些能识破我们伪装的丘丘萨满，直到抵达营地深处，找到并调查那些神秘的雕像。这潜行看起来好流畅哦。调查完雕像后，我们将能造访幽深的秘境，等待我们的将是一只体格异常硕大的丘丘萨满。这丘丘萨满非常强大。 我们需要见招拆招，把他的能力转化为我们的武器。我们将是一只体格异常硕大的丘丘萨满。这丘丘萨满非常强大。
Not very powerful. What's the HP gonna be on this thing? Not HP. What level this is gonna be? 100. Since this thing gonna be very extremely powerful.
我们需要见招拆招，把他的能力转化为我们的武器进行反制。
Oh. I was just saying, wait. My question was, well, not really, because we can see he ain't ult. There's Zhao with Cloud Retainer's ult. I can see her weapon, not her weapon, her machine she built floating around Zhao, and he can jump a little extra higher. If they ult it, we can see how it looks. His leaping capabilities and hers together.
Oh, 见招拆招.
把他的能力转化为我们的武器进行反击。Oh, Nouvellette!Yes!例如击破他召唤的六倍大日落果，使他在地面残留的果汁中摔倒，把他召唤的卷心菜朝他打回去，眩晕住他，还有利用他召唤的大型风场飞。Oh, but no, this is very interesting, though.起来。I don't know if we have something like
this.用下路攻击的冲击波战胜他，等等。用他的力量来战胜他，听起来很刺激啊。除了丘丘人部落的神秘雕像。 在波诡云谲的秘境深处，还有其他来历成谜的敌人正在蓄势备战。每个挑战包含四轮战斗，在不同战斗轮次中，我们可以从数名随机的试用角色中选择两或四位加入队伍。每名角色初始具有两点战役值，每出战一轮就会损失一点。同时，每个挑战都具有独特的激荡战役，会根据队伍中角色战役值的总和提供特定效果。
我们需要留意该效果，并合理加以利用。最终完成挑战，获取奖励，感觉可以借助试用。It's another beat 'em up. Love it。角色去进行尝试一些新的配对和战略。对的，希望旅行者能享受不同的配对带来的战斗体验。除此之外，七圣召唤也有一些。Genius Invocation TCG
更新，除了常规的热斗模式更新。 七圣召唤的铸境岩链也将再次开放，旅行者可以选择不同的附加条件获取积分来领取奖励。其次，精通已有活动也将如期而至，需要培养角色的旅行者们不要错过哦。最后，说到培养角色，针对圣遗物的养成体验。Oh,
the quality of life, another quality of life change they made to the game. Mainly an add, not a change, an add-on.
不要错过。最后，说到培养角色，针对圣遗物的养成体验也在持续优化中。本次
we can customize our loadouts.
增加了圣遗物快速装备的新功能，旅行者可以选择自定一方案。
And then we can do a quick loadout.
或是参考其他旅行者的方案，更方便。
it picks the delicious, most useful sets. We don't have to, you don't have to look through your stuff and see what good. You could, it just pulls it out for you and says, this was what good on him. This is what the people who play this character the most said, this set is good for him. I'm like, we love this. We love this. For people who don't know, this is real good.
方便的装备圣遗物。
We love this.
感觉很实用哎，期待一下，也感谢阿明带来的分享。大伟哥客气了，预祝大家海灯节快乐！海灯节快乐！Happy
Latin right. Is it? Wait, is it the end? Then we still got more.
除了提瓦特的朋友们与我们共度佳节，提瓦特之外，也有其他朋友用自己的方式给我们准备了惊喜。停机见光，尽显锋芒。原神与一加手机的全新联动。 一加原神客勤定制机将在2月底与大家见面。为了让旅行者在移动
Oh, Kojima's so cute, this outfit.
设备游玩时获得更沉浸的体验。原神项目团队推出了游戏状态通讯技术，协同手机厂商一起来优化设备性能，提高原神在手机上的运行表现。在客勤定制手机上，一加技术团队啊基于这套技术进行了深度的适配与实验。 推出了包括原神加载提速、后台网络保活、功耗优化在内的移动端游戏体验调优，陆续会在更多设备上应用。除了技术优化之外，有关联动定制机的外观设计、拟正周边等细节，允许我先卖个关子。一加手机官方账号将在后续公布更多活动详情，那感兴趣的旅行者可以前往关注。除此之外，4.4版本期间。 原神第二章封单篇OST《万流始源之海》也即将与大家见面，专辑共有3张分碟，共收录60余首，由HoYo Mix音乐团队为原神封单地区创作的原神音乐。旅行者们敬请期待。鲤鱼一直都有诸多美好的寓意，吉祥、繁荣、幸福、顺利等等，也正巧。 此次旅行者游历成玉谷，还会有鲤鱼仙人辅警的指引相伴。我代表原神项目组，带着对各位旅行者的感谢与祝福，愿各位旅行者年年安康，诸事顺利，鱼跃龙门，亦有期。And
that's it. And that was that. It only took 1 hour and 38 minutes. I did say almost to an hour, or it was going to be an hour, but almost about 2 hours. Yes. But yeah, just so much is going to be happening. So much, So, let me do like a little speed before we get into the Sims. Let me do a little speed, go back. Obviously, we're getting a new extension of Liyue. Is it Chenyu? Chenyu Village? Or the... Wait, what's the area called? Yeah, Chenyu. Wait, is that the area in general? I know it's probably a portion of the area of the village, but it's very the new area. I'm just saying, it's so pretty, it's so gorgeous. I cannot wait to frolic, cause mayhem by running around and all. And then, of course, a new character, 4-star character. Gaming. Yes, fighting style. Very flashy. It just looks so good. And of course, this is like neon texture glow. Like, really cool. Like, it makes me want to build him. But I'm gonna be too busy building Cloud Retainer, though. But very cool. And of course, Miss Ma'am herself. Right here. Very, her fighting, her combat, everything looks so good. Her alt heals and helps characters plunge, jump in the air. Very good, very good. And of course, her E. Plunging attack and grouping enemies together. We love it. The banners for the first half. Cloud Retainer. I need to learn how to say her name, but it's Cloud Retainer. And Nahida. For my non-Nahida havers, you will be Nahida. Y'all will be Nahida. If you want her, y'all will have her. She's amazing. If you're not gonna get Cloud Retainer. The weapon banner. Her weapon's so good, though, too. And then phase two, Zhao and Yamiko. Two good characters as well. Let me some Zhao, let me some Yamiko. And then more of the new area. So pretty. As I said, gonna be running and causing mayhem. And doing the little world quests that they're gonna have me doing. But it's so good, like immaculate. I lost my mind at this. I was like, oh wow, wait, this is so pretty. And the detail of this right here, I'm like, oh wow, just so detailed. The amount of screenshots people gonna be taking. Just breathtaking. I wonder what's that. Oh, we can see Fontaine. Wait a minute, I just now seen that. Good thing I came back. Just Fontaine right here. Hey Fontaine in the back. And of course, the new boss, which I know, I probably, one of, Cloud Retainer's materials is gonna be from this boss, I'm guessing. So, feel pretty. And of course, the lantern, right, and all, very cute. With the kites. And then, of course, the new skins for the new characters for the characters that already been released that we already know and love. Xing Qiu, his outfit, which is for Fui, cute. And then, of course, Gan Yu's outfit. I love the back of this outfit. The front is cute as well, but the back so cute. The heels, yes. And then Shin Ho's her outfit, eating it up. Gorgeous. Anything else? And of course the mini games and all that gonna be happening for the Lantern, right? We already seen. Of course, get your free leeway character. We love that. For free. We love the free. Yeah, everything that's gonna be happening. And then and then some other events are gonna be happening as well. Which is neat. So yeah. y'all already know me excited. Can't wait for 4.4. Can't wait to see who all from the different nations are coming to the Lantern Rite in Leeway. Can't wait, come, because they didn't say who's coming. They're just saying people from Mondstadt, Inazuma, Sumeru, and Fontaine just gonna come. And they say who in particular, which I like. Of course, they're gonna say that for a secret. Yeah, but let me see what days the update coming. I think it should be because it's a pattern that they do. Next week, no. I think because the update's always on Wednesday with Genshin. So let me see the calendar. Oh, it's gonna be on the 31st. Obviously, it's gonna be on like Tuesday, but around like 11. 12, depending on your time zone and all that and where you live, it gonna be like in the around on the 31st, around that 11-12 area at night. Y'all already know if you see me play and be pulling for characters when they first drop on Tuesday around nighttime, midnight. So yeah, so it gonna be coming right up soon, real soon. We just got a whole week to prepare. But yeah, that was it for watching the 4.4 special program.